Congratulations on your first mission. You've gotten a rather dramatic introduction to life in the OSS. I have every confidence you're going to make me look like a genius for recruiting you. Your new assignment is a dangerous one. We're sending you back into enemy territory, but this time you're going undercover as a Wehrmacht captain. Now, the Germans have carried over some bad habits from the last World War. One is a love for grossly oversized pieces of artillery. You may have heard of the railguns Dora and Gustav. Well, meet their new sister, Greta. It became fully operational last week. This is the only clear photo we've been able to get because they keep hiding the damn thing. They've spent the last 7 days shooting it at the channel. This was a fuel tender, and this was a hospital ship. Greta's actually smaller than the Dora and the Gustav, but it's capable of firing a more powerful shell, and its reduced size gives it a high degree of mobility, so they're always able to move it before our bombers can get there. That's why we're sending you in to do it by hand. Your transport leaves at 1900 hours. Knock her out of commission, Lieutenant. Good luck.
Sorry, sir. Have a good night.
My mistake, sir. Captain.
Sorry, sir. Have a good night. I need reinforcements!
Hello?
Sir, I need to see some identification.
Sorry, sir. Have a good night.
Thank you.
Delivering explosive ordnance onto an enemy target has always been a major element of modern warfare. Artillery, tanks, and bombers evolved into lethal extensions of the mighty German war machine. Goering's Luftwaffe, working in tandem with the Wehrmacht's mighty siege guns, smashed across Europe, the Channel, and Britain herself. But tanks could be stopped, rail guns could be destroyed, and aeroplanes could be shot from the sky.